Blessed be the name of Yah.
We praise you today.
Hallelujah.
We praise you today.
Today, we thank him for his presence. We thank him for giving us an opportunity to be here on today. We're going to bring our minds and our hearts and our thoughts in on this afternoon as we begin our worship time on today. And if you're tuning in by live stream, we welcome you and we say shalom and Sabbath blessings unto you and to everyone and to those of us who are present as well. Shalom, Sabbath blessings to you as well.
Yeah.
Amen. We're going to open up in prayer and then we're going to begin with the Shema. Amen. Father Yah, we thank you today that we are here in your presence. We have the opportunity
yes,
to be here. We thank you that you brought us through the week. You allowed us to see another blessed day, another blessed Sabbath. We thank you, Father, that your blessings are yea and amen.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord.
You allowed the sun to rise on us.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Did.
Thank you for this beautiful day. And we ask that you would meet us here today, that you will be present in our midst today. We know you are here because we are believers and we brought Yeshua with us in our hearts, in our mind, in our spirit on today. We ask, Father Yah, that you would just give us what we need for ourselves today. Lord, if we're in the need of healing, we ask that you would heal us in our bodies, heal us in our minds. Lord, those who are in mental turmoil and anguish, Father, we ask that you would come against that, Lord. We come against the spirit of anxiety on today, Lord. We come against every depression, oh Lord, every thought, oh Father, we ask that you would just clear our minds
yes,
of it
God.
On today.
Yes,
allow
God.
Us to
yes,
be empty vessels, temples that stand
yes.
before you, Lord,
yes.
Yes,
waiting
God.
To be filled by your presence,
yes,
Lord. And we're standing, Lord, like just like Isaiah saw, Lord, your temple coming in, your train, feeling the presence, hallelujah.
Yes,
we ask
God.
That you would fill us, our earthly temples here, Father, that you would be one with us in our midst on today, Lord. And we just thank you in advance for everything.
Yes,
everything.
God.
We bless your name. We give
yes.
you glory on today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We honor you today.
Yes.
We bless your holy name. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We thank you. We're going to start by reading our scripture text found in Deuteronomy chapter 6. I'm going to read the first portion, and then we're going to do Deuteronomy chapter 5 will be our brother Deacon Joseph will be coming with us for that, and then our new covenant scripture as well. So we're going to begin with Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 through 9. Amen.
Amen.
And the scripture reads, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our Yah, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your Yah with all your Elohim, with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be upon your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home, and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your foreheads. Write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates." Amen. Bless the Lord as we move on to the next passage. Come on up and read that for us.
Sure.
Deuteronomy chapter 5.
Yes.
And we're reading 6 through 21.
Yes.
Deuteronomy 5, 6 through 21.
Yes.
I am Yahuwah Eloheka, which brought you out of the land of Mitzrayim, from the house of bondage. You shall have no other Elohim before me. You shall not make you any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above or in the earth beneath, or that is in the waters beneath the earth. You shall not bow down yourself unto them, nor serve them. For I, Yahuwah Eloheka, am a jealous El, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and guard my commandments. You shall not take the name of Yahuwah Eloheka in vain, for Yahuwah will not hold him guiltless that takes his name in vain.
Yes.
Guard the day of the Shabbat to sanctify it as Yahuwah Eloheka has commanded you. 6 days you shall labor and do all your works, but the seventh day is the Shabbat of Yahuwah Eloheka.
Yes.
In it you shall not do any work, you, nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your manservant, nor your maidservant, nor your ox, nor your ass, nor your cattle, nor your stranger that is within your gates, that your manservant and your maidservant may rest as well as you. And remember that you were a servant in the land of Mitzrayim, and that Yahuwah Eloheka brought you out thence through a mighty hand and an stretched out arm. Therefore, Yahuwah Eloheka commanded you to keep the Sabbath. Honor your father and your mother, as Yahuwah Eloheka has commanded you, that your days may be prolonged, and that it may go well with you in the land which Yahuwah gives you. You shall not kill, neither shall you break wedlock, neither shall you steal, neither shall you bear false witness against your neighbor, neither shall you lust after your neighbor's woman, neither shall you lust after your neighbor's house, his field, or his manservant, or his maidservant, his ox, or his ass, or anything that is your neighbor's.
Yes, bless the Almighty.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Matthew or Mark? Mark.
Mark chapter 12.
Yes.
Yes, amen.
Verses 12 through, or 28 through 31.
Amen.
Mark 12, 28 through 31.
Yes.
And one of the scribes came, and having heard them reasoning together, and perceiving that he had answered them well, asked him, which is the first commandment of all? And Yahusha answered him, the first of all commandments is, Hear, O Yashar El, Yahuwah Eloheinu, Yahuwah is one, and
yes,
you shall love Yahuwah Eloheka with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strength.
Yes.
This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
Amen.
There is none greater commandment than these.
Amen.
Bless the Almighty, yes.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. We bless the Lord for the reading.
Yes.
We bless the Almighty for the reading of the scripture text on today.
Yes, yes.
And we give him the glory and the praise for his word. We read this every week so that we will remind ourselves that what the scripture says about what is in the heart and the mind of Elohim.
Yes.
To do right by one another, to live our lives among our neighbors, to do well, to take care of our own self, how we look at ourselves and keep our minds pure before him. And by doing that introspective work, that would help us to live out our lives before men and in the presence of men and women,
yes,
our neighbors, our family members. So these are the reminders that we have. You know, the word covers every area of our lives. We call them 10 commandments, but it's more, and it covers every aspect of our,
yes,
life. It helps us when we have to do our jobs. It helps us when we have to interact with each other. And so we relate to these things. The Most High didn't want us here on the earth without having an ability to how to get along with each other. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Yes. Amen. But Amen. Yeshua, when we read this in Mark chapter 12, verse 28, it gives us an indication that if not only are we considering what Moses gave, but we're also considering that Yeshua said that the most important, even though we have all of the do's and the don'ts and the laws, but he says that you shall love the Lord, same as in what we talked about in Deuteronomy chapter 6, where they give the Shema. He repeats that. He says, "Hear, O Israel." You know, he said, "The Lord is one." It's the same thing.
Yes.
I'm not changing any of that. You're still going to consider the Lord, our Elohim, Yah, is one. Mm-hmm. Amen. And you are to love your Elohim with all of your heart. And when you do that, I'm not coming to change anything. I'm taking this to a new level of love, that not only are you loving Elohim with all of your heart, but you're also loving with your soul and your mind and strength. You're also, the second right next to that is loving your neighbor as yourself. There is no,
yes,
greater commandment. He's saying, you know what? You won't break any, you wouldn't want to break any of the other commandments if you follow these two laws that we give on today. Allow that to lead us and guide us as we interact. Amen.
Amen.
Well, bless the Lord Most High. As you notice, we have a little different today. I'm here, and our overseer, Pastor Mode, he's out in the California area on today. And so we wish him greetings, and we are with him in thought as he is joining in with others on today. And he's conducting himself there on these next couple of days. And we also want to join in by live stream on tomorrow. Hopefully he'll be airing, that he will be ministering out in the San Diego area. So that will be tomorrow. I believe the service begins at 11 a.m. He might be able to add that information onto our service as well, so you can know that information to be able to tune in. And if you're in the San Diego area, those who are following us, we have friends in California. If you're out that way, maybe go by and join him. I believe he has given the announcement information on his web, his Facebook page. So we will be in prayer for those endeavors, and for his safe return back to the Washington area here in our home location in Tacoma. Amen.
Amen.
Well, we bless the Almighty. We're going to go ahead and I believe we have just a couple of songs we will enter in. Amen. Because I don't want to delay on today. We'll be bringing our lesson text. We're going to be not in the Book of Revelation this week, because we will pick up on that next time when Overseer Mo does return. But we will be covering, we will be talking in, as I'm, John chapter 11 is where we will be bringing our word from on today. But before that, we are going to go ahead in song. Amen. We're going to start off with Days of Elijah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. Bless us all.
Yeah.
Days of great trials, famine and darkness and sword. Making Jerusalem a praise in all the earth. We We are the house of Israel. Amen.
Yes.
And we are to be a praise. Our lips, we should have praises on our lips for the Almighty.
Yes.
The natural eye. A great event is being prepared. A war and a wedding. I'll have your place and time.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Soon and not yet is the word that the watchman gives as a strength to the darkness of the night. The ascent is just beyond the horizon.
Lord, the King of Kings,
the Lord of Lords, is preparing for victory. Arise, you sleepers. Shake off your slumber, he calls.
Yes.
Come and fill your lamp.
Yes.
Yeah.
King the Lord, Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Almighty who is our victory.
His great name.
Bless his great name.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Raise up those who will stand unafraid in the name of the Lord.
Do it, Lord.
Who will give no sleep to their eyes.
To our eyes, Lord.
Yes.
No peace or rest given to you, Lord, until you make Jerusalem a praise in all the earth.
That's yes.
I sworn it by your name.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
That's
hallelujah.
What we believe on today. Hallelujah.
Praise the Almighty.
Bless his great name. Amen. You believe that?
Amen. Yes.
He is waiting on us. Amen.
Hallelujah.
He is waiting on us. We know he's going to return.
Yes,
he is. He is waiting on the house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For us to be in unity and for us to increase our faith and believe. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, a great hand of praise unto him. Amen. Amen. Bless his great name. Amen.
Yeah.
Have your seats if you're able. Hallelujah. Bless his great name. We thank you, Lord.
Amen. Yes.
We're going to bring forth our few brief announcements. Amen. This is our weekly service. As you all know, but for those who are live joining us by live stream, we meet on every Sabbath at 12:30 p.m. for our main worship time, and then normally on weekdays, on Sabbaths, we have the 4 p.m. teaching. We will not be having that one on today because our overseer Pastor Mode is out today, so we will not be having our School of Messiah Bible Institute on today. So that will be resumed on, I believe, on next Shabbat, next Saturday, so we will be in prayer for that. But however,
yes,
if you want to catch up, you can use this week to catch up on the lessons that have already been shared. You can find those teachings either on our Voice of Messiah ministry page, or you can go to our ministry webpage at www.ncmmi.20m.com, and you can download those lessons. I believe you can get them there. If not, you can also enroll for the coursework, and you can get some information for that, for the current class that we are currently presently in. So we give the Lord thanks for that. During the week, we have our weekly service. It's on Wednesday night, every Wednesday at 6:30. We meet for prayer, and we also have a prayer line that we do the prayer on. We'll give out that information. We have that prayer line. And 7:30 on Wednesdays, we meet for our Bible teaching, our weekly Bible teaching. So the prayer line for that information is area code 605-313-5500. That's the number to call, area code 605-313-5500. And there's an access code you need to have. The access code is 110385. You enter that in, and you can stay and give your prayer requests on Wednesday at 6:30 on that phone line, and we will pray with you for your needs. Stay on the call with us. We were happy to have those call in and pray with us. So we just go in during that time, and we believe. We believe in prayer. We have faith to believe that the Most High hears and answers prayer. We pray for families. We pray for the needs of our families. We pray for the needs of our friends. We pray for the needs for loved ones near and far. There is no limitation as to how far prayer reaches. Amen.
Yes.
We bring forth those needs before the Most High. We also pray for our nation as we read from when Paul gives instructions to Timothy to pray for kings and rulers. We pray for kings and rulers. We pray for our president. We pray for the nation. We pray for, we don't believe in whether you're Democratic or Democrat or Republican or independent. We're going to pray for all of us as citizens. We don't, we don't just limit to our own party. We pray for everybody. Amen. We pray for the needs of the sick. Lately, the last several weeks, we've been praying for, you know, this past year, actually, because of this pandemic, we have been really lifting up the prayers for those who have been hit with this COVID virus. We believe Psalm 91, that it will not come nigh our dwelling place. We believe it. I've gotten through the whole season, this whole season, this whole COVID, believing and trusting the Most High and lifting up the word. There are some Psalms and different promises I came across, and I listened to them. I get them on the audio, and I just let them just play in my head, just play. And I'll go, sometimes I'll sleep with it on my, in my ear, so that I have the great and precious promises that are in this book. There are, it's loaded with great and precious promises. And the promises are yea and amen. Hallelujah. I don't know where I would be without the promises and knowing that, that no matter what we are going through, that there is an answer for that. Amen. If you're struggling with anxiety, there's an answer for that. If you're struggling with depression, there's an answer for that. So we come together, amen, every week to pray. And we strongly believe that our prayers are being heard.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We get the testimony of victory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Needs met. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. As you may put two and two together, we're going to skip over our history bit on today. I don't have a history bit for you. That will be Overseer Mo to share those nuggets of history and such. So on the flip side, it means we'll probably be out of here maybe 30 minutes earlier than we normally are.
We love you, Overseer.
So I'll tell him that. So, but so there's a little positive side to that. But I won't behold you for super long. But we will share on today something that came into my heart, into my spirit earlier this week as I was reading, and it just kind of came into to talk about on today. So we're going to go to the book of John, St. John chapter 11 is where we're going to take our text from on today. I feel as though we just need to stir up faith in the house of worship. We need to stir up faith in the house of worship. I don't know. I think this past year, with the pandemic and everything that has occurred, I just believe that people might have lost a little bit of faith. I know a lot of people lost hope. Seeing friends and loved ones. Some of you have even had loved ones who have lost people to this plague. And I don't want to give any glory or any honor to it at all. I just say it is not for us. I stand on that. I don't care what nobody believes or says. I stand on the word that it is not for us. And like I said, Psalm 91 says that if we can speak out against the plague, that it not come nigh our dwelling. Amen.
Yes.
So I am just so grateful to the Most High. And not only just because of this pandemic, but some people have lost courage and faith, not because of loved ones who've lost from the plague, but from all kinds of reasons. Some people have had family members who've taken their own lives. I've heard stories. It's just a season where we may be under an emotional and attack, an anxiety attack, depression. All these things as we look around and we may be discouraged, but I'm going to stand before you today and tell you to stir up your courage.
Yes.
Stir up your mind. Stir up your strength. Stir up your faith. And so if we can say a few words in order to do that, I would appreciate it. I'm going to ask if you could take a second. I can just run over there and get it. I'm going to step away from the podium for 2 seconds. I'm going to get my notes. I did have some notes jot down, so I don't want to be without my notes. on today because I want to say what the Lord said to me as it was flowing. Yeah. You know what I mean? So sometimes you just go with your notes to recall the things that come to you when the Lord is sharing. Amen. So we're going to read from John chapter 11. I'm pretty much going to read the story and kind of interject here and there as we go. But we're going to be on a little bit of a continuous journey as we go through John chapter 11 on today. Amen. So we're going to read. Now, a man named Lazarus was sick. He was from Bethany. We're starting at verse 1. The village of Mary and her sister Martha. This Mary, whose brother Lazarus now lay sick, was the same one who poured perfume on the Lord and wiped his feet with her hair.
Yeah.
So the sisters sent word to Jesus, Yeshua, Lord, the one you love is sick. Somebody say, Lazarus was sick.
Lazarus was sick.
Amen. So I want to pause for just a second right here because when I saw this first part, I says, wait a second. This is the same Mary who, when she saw Yeshua was in his presence, she poured perfume on his feet and wiped it with her hair. Now, I went to kind of look, because I always like to say, okay, where did we find that? I remember reading that before, but you know what? What's interesting, and I didn't notice that until I started reading this, the incident is recorded in John chapter 12, which is the next chapter over, and you see in verses 1 through 3, it tells about that. So this is a recapping. So as John is relaying this story about Lazarus, he knows the whole ending. Sometimes when we read in the passage and we really take the chapters and the verses and the text like literally, like as we're reading it, and we fail to realize that it is a recap, a summation of these order of events. And they're not all the events. I've heard people say, literally think that everything that is written was everything that was done by Yeshua, but that's not the case. Because John himself said, if we could not even hold, the book couldn't hold everything that Jesus, Yeshua did and said, we wouldn't have enough books in the earth to be able to hold and write it all about.
Yeah.
So he's covered, but he was so excited about telling this story and writing it that he even went ahead of himself. He said that this is that same Mary. He don't talk about it until chapter 12, if you'll notice that. It says 6 days, chapter 12, verse 1, says 6 days before the Passover, Yeshua Jesus arrived at Bethany where Lazarus lived. Now, we know this is an after the fact. It's because it says whom Jesus had raised from the dead. That same Lazarus. So we already, if you look ahead, you already know the ending of the story. It says he was raised from the dead. But it says here, a dinner was given in Yeshua's honor. Martha served. Now, this is the same Martha who another passage where it says she was constantly busy serving, right? She was the one that chose to do all that. She was upset because her sister Mary decided to sit down at Yeshua's feet and learn of him. And she said, Lord, I'm in here and I'm just busy. I'm just doing all that. She don't even want to get up and give me a hand and help me. She was very disturbed by that. And Yeshua told her, he said, you have a lot of things that trouble you. You can find that in Luke chapter 10, verse 38 through 41. But Yeshua said, you have a lot of things that you are concerned about, Martha. He said, but Mary has chosen the better part. She has chosen to sit at my feet, right? He says, you are worried and upset about many things, but only one thing is needed. Mary has chosen what is better. So this is that same Martha that was serving. They put together this dinner for Yeshua, and she invited him. And Lazarus was there, and he is whole, and he is sitting there. And she took, and this is where it talks about, she took the pint of pure nard, an expensive perfume, poured it over his feet, and wiped it with her hair. Made them all upset about all of that expensive perfume, but he said she had saved this for me. But anyway, John, he goes ahead and he tells it, and you see it's happening. He talks about it in chapter 11. He kind of was just wanted to give some identifying points about this, who this Mary was, and who her sister Martha was, and who this Lazarus was. So let's continue to read. But this is how we know that this event had taken place already. Hallelujah. It says, when he heard this, after they told him, Lord, the one you love is sick.
Uh-huh.
So he was just sick at this time that they came to him. They tried to do whatever they could to spare their brother. And wherever Yeshua was, he was in the village. They went to him and they said, our brother is sick, but we know that you're able to heal him. And he said, when he heard this, Yeshua said, this sickness will not end in death. No, it is for Yah Elohim, God's glory, so that Yah's son may be glorified through it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeshua loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. It's very clear that he loved them. Yet when he heard that Lazarus was sick, he stayed where he was 2 more days. Then he said to his disciples, let us go back to Judea. But Rabbi, they said, a short while ago, the Jews tried to stone you. Yes. And yet you are going back there. Okay, let's pause here for a moment. So Yeshua got the news about his dear friends, how they were hurting over their brother, Lazarus being sick. So he told them, he said, this sickness will not end. Now they're going to put emphasis on the word end, in death. He didn't say, your brother will not die. He said it will not end in death. Meaning death is not going to be the finality. It's not going to be the final outcome of this situation. He says, because he already knew in his mind what the Most High had assigned for him to do. Amen.
Yes.
So he told them it's not going to end in death. But he delayed. He delayed himself. And then after 2 days, he told his disciple, let's go ahead and go back. Now, let's pause here because I want to walk you through something here that I found very interesting in this. That when he came, what they're referring to, when he said, they said, Rabbi, a short while ago, not just long ago, if you go back to the previous chapter, in chapter 10, it says that they had tried to stone him. John chapter 10, verse 31, is just a flip page over. We're not moving that far through these chapters here today because all the information is right here. So if you go to chapter 10, before verse 31, there was a conversation that Yeshua had with the Jews. Amen? And they accused him of blasphemy. This is where he was. And they, when he was there in the presence of a Jerusalem, he was there for the Feast of Dedication. It was winter. And he was at the temple. He was walking around. And we would call this the Hanukkah season. Amen. We just got finished celebrating what we consider Yeshua's birth. Now we're dealing with this part of the Feast of the Dedication in the temple. And this was a time period we consider as in the month of what we would consider Hanukkah month. So usually that's in December, the winter month. And this is where Yeshua was.
Yeah.
And it says they gathered around him. How long will you keep us in suspense? So he was saying, tell us plainly, who are you? And what are you here to do? Are you the Christ? They was expecting him. So there's a lot of history in this, in that question, are you the Christ? Are you the Messiah? And so when he began to tell them, he says, the miracles I do in my Father's name, they speak for me. I don't have to tell you, outline all the details about why I'm here and what the Father has assigned for me to do. But he said that the miracles that I do speak for me. Why did Yeshua have to come to Jerusalem and perform these miracles?
Yes.
These miracles were necessary because they gave testimony as to what the Most High had assigned for him to do. And he says, but do not believe me because you are not my sheep. He straight told them, you are not my sheep. He offended them. How dare he tell them? They thought that they were so in tune with the things of Elohim. They thought they were in tune with God. They thought they had that. They knew Yah. But they said, he said, my sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. And then what really got to them was he went through all of that, but that wasn't why they picked up stones. They picked up stones because they accused him of blasphemy because he said, my father who has given, he said, no one is able to snatch them from me out of my hand. Why? I got power because I and my father are one. I and the father are one. And at that statement, that is what got them to such a state of mind. They went ballistic to say, I can imagine just in my mind them screaming, ah, how dare you have the boldness to say you and the Father are one. And verse 31 says, and this wasn't the first time they picked up stones against him. Because it says, again, they picked up the stones to stone him. But Yeshua said to them, I showed you many miracles. What are you stoning for me for? Which one of these? And they said, not the miracles. Oh, we can take the miracles. They could take all day long you doing the miracles. But it was because of that statement that he said. And they thought that they were following the law. But the ironic thing about it is that he said, the scripture cannot be broken. What about the one whom the Father set apart and his very own and sent into the world? Why then do you accuse me of blasphemy because I said I am God's son? Amen. So you can read that and know why that was stated in chapter 11, verse 8. They said, but Rabbi, we just had that encounter when we were so glad to get out of there. We got out of there with our lives. Because not only when the rocks start flying, were they going after Yeshua, but anybody that was a part of him or with him was also going to be hit with the stones. I'm sure that's what his disciples were thinking. We barely got out of there with our lives. He says, a short while ago, the Jews tried to stone you. Yet you want to go back? They couldn't understand. But Yeshua knew what it was that he needed to do. He just couldn't leave his friends that were suffering and had so much that they were dealing with. And so he knew that they had to go back. So he was not a far distance journey, but he delayed. You will find out later that he was not a far distance journey.
Yes.
But he still delayed. Not only did he wait 2 days, but by the time he got to where to Mary and Martha, 4 days had passed. And so you have to ask yourself, what was Yeshua doing? What was he taking so long to do that he did not show up before Lazarus died? But we know that he had it in his mind what he was coming to do. Amen. And sometimes our faith is going to be tested.
Yes.
Amen. We're going to cover that in just a minute. Hallelujah. Let's keep reading. Verse 9, Yeshua answered, are there not 12 hours of daylight? A man who walks by day will not stumble, for he sees by this world's light. It is when he walks by night that he stumbles, for he has no light. Yeshua is telling him, I'm the light, and I'm here in the day with you right now.
Yeah.
You got to be able to see what I'm doing. Don't be confused. Sometimes we walk around, we don't understand what the direction the Lord is taking and showing. But that's what he was showing his disciples. He said, after he had said this, he went on to tell them, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I am going there to wake him. They didn't understand. They said, later he said, Lord, if he sleeps, he will get better. Yeshua had been speaking of his death, but his disciples thought he meant natural sleep. So then he told them plainly, just straight told them, Lazarus is dead, y'all. We delayed, but he was sick. And this sleep I'm talking about is not just that he is in a deep sleep. He is gone. He is dead.
Yes.
It's bleak. The situation is pretty from a natural state of reference. It looked pretty dire and pretty bleak. But he already knew, and he said, and for your sake, I am glad I wasn't there. What a thing to say. And for your sake, I am glad I was not there.
Yes.
So that you may believe.
Yes.
Well, let's go to him. Sometimes the The Lord has to speak to us. You know, and it makes you think about some of the situations that we find ourselves in, and we pray while it's still some hope of the situation turning itself around. Have you ever been in that situation?
Yeah.
Where you say, oh, Father, if you just answer, if you answer my prayer tomorrow, I'll be able to pay that thing right on time before if they call, they say it's late, or if they just give me that what I need today, Father, to take care of this is due, and if you just do that for me now, or if you heal my body today, I may not have to go for that surgery. How about that? If you just do it while I still have a little bit of ability to have a, to have an impact on it.
Yeah.
I mean, it can have an effect right now. If you just, we seem like we want to dictate. Have you ever been there where you felt like you just needed to dictate and run the show a little bit, dictate to the Most High when it is he needs to answer that prayer for you? I've been in that situation. I know we all have been in that situation. That you just get in your mind. You already got it figured out, got a time schedule for it. If he does it, then I'll be okay. If we just get that in the mail, we got a few days of checking the time, checking our calendar. And well, we have faith. We got faith to see it coming, right? We have faith. And, so, and for some of us, our level of faith is only just there. As long as we still have a measure ability to see the outcome of it. Right in the time frame. Oh, yes, Lord, right in the time frame of when we want to dictate that outcome needs to happen. Whew. Oh, this is talking to me today, because there have been many times in my life and I feel like I'm really exercising faith just as long as it happened before this deadline. Just as long as it happened before they come after me.
Yeah.
Just as long as you give it to me, Lord, before they start blowing up my phone.
Yes.
About what things I got to take care of and what to do and what has to be, you know, and just before, you know, we've been in situations, hallelujah. And I just feel the spirit of testimony, because that's what Yeshua was trying to indicate to them. This is, I'm glad I wasn't there, because you know what? You all need a testimony.
Yeah.
You need an observation with your own mind and your own eyes. To see the power at work.
Amen.
How that when you don't see, when you don't have light, it is not illuminated to you. You haven't had the privilege to understand and see it all. He was trying to tell us, sometimes y'all just walk in darkness. Mm-hmm. And don't even see. You got light right here with you.
Amen.
Yes.
You got 12 hours of daylight, and that's all you want to just do. But he said, I'll be your light even when you walking in the darkness.
Amen.
And yes. I am the light in you, and I am in you. I am that light that will illuminate
Hallelujah. The
situation. Hallelujah. And we look at what Mary and Martha and Lazarus was dealing with. They came to him while it was still light. It was still light. It was still a possibility of some outcome coming in their favor. They didn't want to see their brother suffer any longer. They didn't want to see him go through death. Amen.
Amen.
But Yeshua said, it's okay. It's not going to end in death.
Amen.
And he just wanted to build faith and the testimony. But listen here. In verse 16, we're going to walk through this whole thing. Then Thomas, because he said he's going back, right? And he said, let's go. It's time to go. But you know what? I have to shake my head sometimes and scratch my head, because amongst the disciples, we have so many different personalities, right?
Amen.
We have so many. I don't know why Yeshua chose the ones he chose. He chose some of them were gangbusters. Some of them were bad boys. Some of them were just rogue. I mean, Peter cutting people's ears off.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, Judas betrayed. I mean, what a bunch of gangbusters he chose. Out of all, he could have had some pristine Pharisaic people. Man. He could have had some. He could have been like, bam, let's just take this thing and run
yes.
with it. You know,
yes.
Yeah, he could have. He had a choice of everybody. He could have went right through the temple and did a few things. He could have said a few things. They would have known exactly. Their eyes would have been open as to who was in their midst. He could have chose from the select of them. He could have chose from the priest to follow him and walk this out with him. But did he do that? He did not. Sadly, he did not. He chose some doubters. He's got Thomas here in verse 16. He says, this Thomas, called Didymus, said to the rest of the disciples, come on now, he didn't even have the boldness just to even say it. He He tells the rest of them, well, let's go then. Let us also go, that we may die with him. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Do you see that? He's saying Lazarus, he's already dead. We about to go back where they tried to kill us all. They just tried to stone us. He don't even remember that. That just happened. That just happened.
Yeah.
We just left with our life. We ain't but 4 days away from this event. Amen. And he want us to go back. So he is the doubter. He is, what else? I wrote something here. I said he was not only the doubter, but he was the mocker too. This is mockery, he's saying. That spirit of mockery rose up in him. And sometimes when you try to operate in faith and belief and you're strong, sometimes you got to be careful of the things that are being spoken around you.
Amen.
He said, you're going back there and you will be killed as well. And not only just he's not willing to take himself out, he's willing to take us out too. He's willing to have them wipe us all out. And let's just prepare. Let's just prepare to die with him. You know, so that is what Yeshua's circle looked like and what he had to deal with in his mind, in his hearing. But can you imagine the focus that you have to be Yeshua? Can you imagine?
Amen.
The focus that Jesus, Yeshua, had to have. Oh my goodness. My mind is just like being blown right now, because when you're thinking about all the people that were around you and the things that are being said to you, but yet you still have the consciousness of mind and thought to know assuredly who you are. You know he knew who he was and what he came to do. Amen. Hallelujah. So now this location where they were going, it says in verse 17, on his arrival, Yeshua found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Bethany was less than 2 miles from Jerusalem. Now John makes it a point to bring this out. I want to know what was going on. Yes. I can do 2 miles in less than 30 minutes. You know, and that's walking. So it took them several days to get to where they were going from Jerusalem to Bethany. You know, and so John doesn't indicate what it is that why Yeshua's late. He didn't just want him to be dead. Like when you still, there's levels of death in this. I don't know if y'all understand.
Yes.
But the medical field, they understand there's levels to death. Okay. Yeah. So when you can die, I've had somebody die, you know, and I've had somebody die, but we could save them. We saved them. Because you get in there with a quickness, you get your CPR, you can render CPR, you can get them going, you can get that heart pumping. Because with death, there's a process of death. You can be dead. And then there's still some things going on. Your brain is not all the way dead. That your heart can stop pumping, because that's clinically dead. But there's still things going on in your body. There's still, you know, there's still signals that can be reactivated. You know, there's still oxygen that can be recirculated into your lungs to get your heart back pumping. So that's why they say timing is everything. If somebody dies in front of you out on the street and they just have a heart attack, clinically they're dead. They're dead. If there's no intervention, they will remain dead. But there have been people who have fallen dead, and within an hour or maybe 2 hours, maybe even 4 hours, if the ambulance can get there and they can render them, put some stuff. They got all kinds of things now. They can bring you back. They got all kinds of techniques now. They can pump stuff into your veins and get you going. They don't want to see you dead. And so they do with that. And so there are some levels to this. And then you've got this, but Yeshua, he waited. So at this point, Lazarus was very much dead.
Dead.
4 days, so dead that it says, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them in the loss of their brother. When Martha heard that Yeshua was coming, she went out to meet him, but Martha stayed at home. Lord, Martha said to Yeshua, if you had been here, my brother would not have died.
Yes.
But I know that even now, Elohim will give you whatever you ask. She really was acknowledging the situation. Now, you got two kinds of different people with different kinds of faith. Now, Martha has a measure of faith here. I don't know what she meant by this statement. I don't know if she envisioned whatever she was envisioning. She said, the reality is, my brother is dead. That's another level of faith. How many of us can acknowledge the power and purpose and the ability of the Most High, even in the midst of a present reality? If your present reality that, yeah, the situation is so dire, it's so out of my control, it's so out of my hand, there is nothing that I myself can do. You tried everything.
Yeah.
But there is nothing that you can do. But that is another level of faith. The immature Christian prays and believes for things they still have control over.
Yeah.
They believe in God, but they still have control over the outcome to some degree. A little level of more maturity is when you have lost the ability to control the situation.
Yeah.
And you acknowledge you do not have any type of anything, any say over it. She knew in her own power that she could not change the present reality of her brother Lazarus being dead. And there are times we have that situation. We move on to the next thing. Father, your will be done. Mm-hmm. Whatever it is, we've lost things. We've had loss in our lives. We've had loss where we knew we couldn't save a home. We knew we couldn't save a possession. We knew we couldn't change the fact that the bank was calling a note due or going to foreclose on a mortgage or whatever anybody's situation is. Or the cancer is at a stage 4. You know, there's so many situations that when it gets to its extreme, we just have to say, you know what? Hands go up. You ever been at a situation where your hands just have to go up?
Yes.
I don't even know what I can do now.
Amen.
There's nothing I can even do.
Yes.
And that's where Martha was. But she had the level of faith to say that even now I know whatever you ask for, I'm connected. She got a glimpse of a connection that he had. She understood and said, let me tell you something, that the word says before you can even receive anything, you must first realize who he is.
Amen.
Right? And he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Amen.
Amen. So we're not going to get anything from Elohim. We're not going to get anything from the Most High if we don't first acknowledge who he is. Amen. And she acknowledged him that the Most High will give you whatever you ask for, even in this hour, with it being so dire. And this, what did Yeshua say to her? He says, your brother will rise again.
Amen.
Yeah.
Rise again. Why he used the words rise again? He didn't just say, I'm coming here to heal him. I'm going to get him up, and we're going to just bring. He kind of spoke in a duality language. You know, he said, he will rise again.
Yes.
And, you know, sometimes that's like somebody saying to you when you're at your ends, wits end, it's gonna get better. You know, we're all gonna have peace and be in paradise and things are gonna work out in the end. And you know, sometimes that's what we hear when we're struggling and someone is trying to give you an encouragement. You don't always receive it that way. You see it like,
I know.
And sometimes you don't wanna hear about the far and beyond. And that's what she was thinking. I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day. She had taken it all the way to the end times, you know.
Yeah.
We're all gonna die and we're all gonna rise up.
Amen.
And you're gonna come for all of us. And so he had to make it very clear to her. He said to her, I am the resurrection.
Yes.
And the life. He who believes in me will live.
Yes.
Even though he dies.
Amen.
And whoever lives and believes in me will never die.
Will never die.
Do you believe this?
Yes,
I do. He challenged her. Do you believe? Now, let me tell you something. I want to bring out a one point, and then we'll continue with this. The one point I want to bring out. This is a story. Have you ever heard a story about a person? And the person has literally nothing to do with the story. John is relaying this story about Lazarus. But the story, Lazarus in this story had nothing to do with this story. I realized that as I was studying this today, or this week, and then today, this morning, I read it, and I read it again, and I said, wait a second. This is a story about a man who died, who was sick and died. He did three things. He was sick, he died, and he rose up again.
Yeah.
It doesn't even talk about how he felt before he died. It doesn't talk about him saying anything, mm-mm, when he rose up, and when he was called back. There's no place,
amen,
where Lazarus speaks or tells his side of the story. He doesn't say he had faith. Oh, I believed the whole time. I just knew if my sisters would just get the Lord and get his attention, I just had faith to believe I wasn't going to die, or if I did die. We don't have anything, no words. We don't even know whether he had faith at all. So that spoke to me, because that spoke to me that sometimes we have to just have faith for each other. We have to have faith and believe. Sometimes people don't even have the ability to believe for their own situation.
Yeah, that's right.
There is a lot of people that don't believe and have faith to believe for their own situation. But we can still stand. We used to call it standing in proxy. I remember we go to the altar, we have an altar call, and somebody who may have been sick, and we used to say, I'm standing in proxy for my loved one. And they will be in the hospital. We'd be at the altar. And that was a connection that we would make for them on their behalf. We would be that person standing in proxy to them. So this was the situation with Mary and Martha. They were standing in proxy for their brother Lazarus. He had nothing to do, and everything that happened had nothing to do with Lazarus at all. Every person who witnessed what took place, it was a testimony to them. But John is talking, relaying the story about a man named Lazarus.
Yes.
And so this is what he told her. He says, if you believe, there wasn't no more hope for Lazarus to believe. He said, but if you believe that I am the resurrection and the life, he who believes in me will live, even though he dies.
Amen.
Yes.
That is amazing. That seems, if you really think about it with your own natural mind, that's impossible. If I'm already dead, how am I going to live? How am I even going to believe? So that makes you know it was others who were believing. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die.
Yeah.
So she said, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of Elohim, who was to come into the world. See, they all knew because of the timing of when he was supposed to come into the world. Amen.
Amen.
And it says, and after she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary. Now, the story goes that Mary was also there. She was back in the house grieving, and all of the Jews and Yeshua never left from where he was to enter. He was in Bethany, but he never went to the house where everybody else was. She went back and called Mary and brought her sister. Mary quickly gets up. And she gets up and just runs out of the house. And it says all the Jews that were there in the house comforting her, they saw her. They saw her get up. And she quickly ran out of the house. They noticed how quickly she got up in verse 31. And they said they follow her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there.
Yes.
When Mary reached the place where Yeshua was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, Lord. She said the same thing as her sister Martha. If you had just been here, my brother would not have died. See, they both had the faith, the level of faith, a prevention. You're going to prevent him. But how many of us have the faith that he will intercede on our behalf? Hallelujah.
My God.
There will come a time, hallelujah, we may not always have our situation prevented. Mm-hmm. If we can just get that in our understanding, we may not always have what we're going to go through prevented. But the Most High sent Yeshua to intercede on our behalf.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And what kind of faith do you have? Do you just have the faith? This is the question I want to ask you. Do you have just have the faith for the living, for that which is vibrant, for that which is healthy, for that which is enduring, and for that which is showing some potential. But it takes a different kind of faith to have a faith to resurrect something that is perceived to be dead already. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Do we have the faith to resurrect something that is speak life into something by our faith? Amen.
Amen.
I mean, if we may not know what our future is going to hold. We may not understand where the Most High is taking us tomorrow. Mm-hmm. We may not know what we're at this stage in our life right now. Some of us are in various stages in our life right now. And some things don't look like your vision that we might have had in the past. And it looks like that thing is just dead and gone. Mm-hmm. I'm never going to be that master craftsman. I'm never going to be that musician. I'm never going to be that master of anything or that person who has my own business like I really, really want it thriving. And we saw those things years ago for ourselves. And some of us, as we even age through life, we seem like we just decide that, well, it don't look like the things that I might have had in my heart to do. I wanted to visit some places. I wanted to see some things. And a lot of us, our hope may be gone. But I tell you on today that Yeshua is able to resurrect the life and put life back in that thing.
Yeah,
he sure is.
He's able to breathe back into that thing. I don't care if it's been dead a year, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, 40 years. He's able to resurrect life back into that purpose that he has for us. Amen. So let me make a point that Lazarus, like I said, it's about Lazarus, but it really wasn't about Lazarus. Lazarus, there's some who have died to be a martyr.
Yeah.
Lazarus did not die in order to be a martyr. Can we see that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Lazarus died to be a testimony.
Amen.
Yeah.
Some of us go through things. Some people will die because of their faith, and they will be martyred. But some of us will go through persecution and will, ooh, hallelujah, I feel that.
Glory.
Some of us will go through, but we will be alive and remain.
Amen.
Because the Most High is going to use that as a testimony for those of us who are still living.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise
if you came through last year and you did not die as a result of the plague and as a result of everything that was around us, then you are here to be a testimony.
Yes.
That the Most High has the power.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Psalm 91, we possessed it and we said we were not going to die, but we were going to live.
Yeah.
And we're going to see the salvation.
Amen.
Of Elohim. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He's calling some of us to be martyrs, but some of us are just going to be testimonies, walking the earth, being able to say that we knew what the doctor said was it would end in death, but Yeshua Jesus said, I'm going to heal you and it's not going to end in death.
Amen.
Yes.
And that's what he did here with Lazarus. And that's what he's doing in our lives on today. Some of us were lost in sin and dying. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In sin, and it was taking our minds and causing us to do things that we did not have any control over our own thoughts and our own bodies.
Yes.
Doing things and living things and causing death to come into our lives on a daily basis as we're walking in death out in the world. So many, hallelujah. Glory, but the Yeshua found us and said, you will not die in this state.
Yeah.
You will not die in your sins.
Yeah.
You will not die in doing these drugs and taking all manner of pills and doing all these things that call in your body death.
That's right.
Hallelujah. But he had faith to believe for you. Have faith to believe for me. He had faith to believe for us even before we had any faith to believe for ourselves. Amen? That's why I said that we were like Lazarus. We just was dead bones. We just didn't even have no ability to see life for our own selves. And every last one of us was in that sin-sick state until the Lord found us and said, you will live. You will live and you will not die. And you will see salvation. Glory. And so as all the Jews came running out to see where Mary was, it says she reached the place where Jesus was. She asked him if you had been here. But he said when Yeshua saw her weeping, and the Jews had come along with her. Everyone's crying. Everyone's in grief. Everyone's rending their clothes, and they're visibly showing their grief. Oh, glory. Yes, Holy Amen. Spirit. They are visibly weeping and visibly in torment Amen. And visibly crying and visibly in anguish. It says he was deeply moved in spirit and trouble. And he just asked, where have you all laid her? Where have you laid him? Where is Lazarus at? And she said, come and see. And this is the second place where I've seen in this verse, chapter 11, verse 35, it says Jesus wept, Yeshua wept. Amen. We know he wept over Jerusalem, but I had not realized before that he also wept for Lazarus, even though he knew what he was going to do. I don't know if he was so much weeping for the situation or weeping because they're all in such, and he was so moved with compassion. And what I got from this was, even when we're going through the tough times in our lives, we have a Savior who feels for us, and he feels what we're going through. He is so in touch with our anguish. He is so in touch with our anxiety and our state of mind. And it said that he wept. But the word, when you look this word, it's not the same type of level of grief that they were weeping. They were outwardly given a you know, wailing. He wasn't wailing and weeping. He was weeping, but he was silently. He still had a confidence, but he was weeping out of compassion. And you know, and so sometimes we may feel as though, you know, we're visibly like, oh, this situation is so burdensome, mm-hmm. and we're weeping, but even though Yeshua, you can feel sometimes the Holy Spirit will comfort you.
Amen.
And you can always yes. feel that he's almost like, he's saying, I feel what you're feeling.
Yes.
I know what you're going through. And you'll feel sometimes that loving comfort arm. I felt that when I had to put my father to rest last October. I felt the Holy Spirit just compassionately giving me an embrace. I felt it, that it was just as if someone gives you a hug. But he also, in his compassion and weeping, he's whispered, it's okay. Everything is okay.
Amen.
You're going to see him again.
Amen.
It's all going to be all right. And so even though he is weeping with us, he is also comforting us
yes,
and
yes.
letting us know that yes. this life is not ending in death. And yes. I am so grateful to the Most High that those we have lost, we need to be comforted.
Amen.
To know I am so grateful Amen. That I have a promise for my tomorrow. You have a promise for your tomorrow. You already know what the eternal
yes.
outcome is. If you
yes.
are a believer, you already know what eternity holds for us.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Eternity holds great things for us. Amen.
Amen.
And where
yes.
Yeshua is, and where the Holy Spirit is, hallelujah, we are comforted. Amen. So we're going to wrap this up. Hallelujah. And it says Yeshua, when he saw them weeping, he said, see how the Jews, everyone saw him, see how much he loved him. But some of them said, could not he, here we go, mockers again. You're always going to have those who have faith and to hold those who have understanding. But then there were mockers among him.
Yeah.
He says, could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man I kept this man from dying, you know?
Yeah.
It's so sad that they just could say that to about him. That we saw the miracles that he did. I mean,
yes.
we know he had the power to prevent him from dying if he just would have been here. You know, and so even in the midst of all of this doubt and all the mockery, Yeshua still decided to do what he was going to do.
Amen.
And it yes. says Yeshua once more deeply moved. He came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. He said, take away the stone.
Yes.
Remove that stone out of there.
Yes.
And here is in the mind of our flesh, You know, we're saying, well, I don't know about that. By now, he's going to be stinking.
Yeah.
It says, did not I tell you that if you believe, you would see the glory of Elohim?
Yes.
So they took away the stone. Even though Martha said that, they took away the stone. And he said, Father, I thank you. Let's read verse 41. Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me.
Amen.
But I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me. And with a loud voice, when he had said this, Yeshua called in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out.
Yes.
So Yeshua prayed and said, Lord, he already knew all eyes were on him. This is like the stage, you know, the platform. All eyes on him, right?
Amen.
And he's saying, Father, already the confidence that he had,
Amen.
Already knowing that what he came to do and that his Father was going to work this miracle. Like I said, Lazarus was just being used to be a testimony before these great people.
Amen.
And he said, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, his hands and feet, strips of linen, and a cloth around his face. Not only did he rise up to life, but he was bound up at that point. So Yeshua said, let him go. Take off the grave clothes and let him go. Amen, amen. Let him freeze. He can't move. You got him all bound up. Let him go. Amen. So all the people around him that saw this great, great miracle, this was just not just a miracle, but a sign and a wonder.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Of what Yeshua came to do. Hallelujah. He came there to Jerusalem.
Yes.
Preaching with signs and wonders following. But what did he came? This was a part of what he came to do. He came to preach the power that was in the kingdom. He came to preach the power that he was bringing with the kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're going to close with this. But I wanted to tell you that if you are a citizen, hallelujah, we are a citizen of a greater kingdom.
Amen.
We are a citizen. This same kingdom that Yeshua came preaching and performing signs and wonders and working miracles, we are also part of that same kingdom, and it operates by faith. Faith unlocks the door.
Amen.
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 Hope. We have the key and the faith. We have the territory that we can claim in the kingdom. But we have to have faith in order to operate and to make it manifest for our lives. Amen.
Amen.
So I want to offer you a citizenship to this kingdom. If you are a blood-born, bought believer, hallelujah, you have a sweet, you know, just like we are citizens in this United States of America, we have kingdom, this is a kingdom, our country, basically. We have certain rights as being born here. We have been given certain rights as a citizen, right? So when you are a citizen of the United States, you can drive on our streets, when you can have access to getting a driver's license as a citizen. You have the privilege of paying the king's great taxes as a citizen.
Yeah.
You have the privilege of having half of your paycheck go towards your health care and medical care as a citizen. We have a lot of things that we have rights and claims to as a citizen of this kingdom.
Yes.
Of the United States of America. And so we can understand that in the natural, but it's the same within the kingdom. In the kingdom, you have rights and benefits.
Mm-hmm.
And part of those benefits is healing.
Amen.
Part of those benefits is having the needs met. Amen. And just like in any kingdom, we do contribute to that kingdom. The Most High has given us certain things and concepts in his word. He says the first fruits that belongs to him. He was trying to get them to understand that concept. In the older covenant, he was pointing out those concepts to them of tithing and giving as a part of this collective body and the citizenship. You all have that as well. And we also have that when we give our gifts unto the Lord Most High.
Yes.
We have access to all the benefits and the paths to citizenship. Hallelujah. If you are out there listening by live stream and you do not know the Lord Yeshua, you can get a path to become a citizen in this great kingdom by first being born again.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we become a citizen by being born. Just like we're born into this country to become a citizen, we can be born into the kingdom of Elohim by becoming bloodborn, by accepting Yeshua Jesus as our Lord and Savior. We become a citizen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of this great nation. Hallelujah. But not only that, but part of the benefits of being a citizen in this great kingdom is healing, is having our bodies to be healed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
To pray for our families and our children to have safety. Amen.
Amen.
I've had many things in my life, hallelujah, that I know that because of prayers that have been offered up for me, that the Lord has kept me safe.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. He's given us safety from the enemy. He also, he performed signs and wonders. He cast out demons and devils among the people of because all of these things they had allowed to come in. And so when Yeshua came, he came teaching and preaching the order of the kingdom. And these are some of the things that the kingdom offers. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
To us as citizens. I am so grateful to the Most High Elohim. I am so grateful. Hallelujah. That I don't have to worry when I have a need.
Amen.
I can come to him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Bless the Almighty. Amen. Praise the Most High. We're going to wrap this up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. But I want us to think about the resurrecting power. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is available to us. As kingdom citizens.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If we need healing on today, as a kingdom citizen, we have access to healing.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We need financial breakthrough. As a kingdom citizen, we have access to ask. He says, ask me anything in my name and don't doubt. Don't doubt and it shall be given unto us. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And Lord, we just thank you today that we don't have to have need when everything around us may be going under. People have lost so many things. We think about all those who have lost homes. They've lost so many things in fire and everything that has been taken from them. But we can believe that the Lord, by faith, he gives us back to us. Amen. These things.
Yes,
his great name. Amen. We are going to believe Elohim for our needs on today.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're going to pray first before we enter into our time of communion. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to pray. I'm going to play this. Hallelujah. This song has been in my spirit all week about resurrecting power. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So pray as we give thanks and we rejoice. Hallelujah. By your spirit. Hallelujah. I will rise. And I speak to anybody with this prayer today that the resurrecting King is resurrecting us. He can resurrect your need. Hallelujah. No matter what is gone, what has died in our lives, the resurrecting power of the Almighty, hallelujah, can resurrect that thing in us. I don't care if it's a dream. I don't care if it's your vision. I pray for marriages right now. I pray for marriages right now. Hallelujah. That are struggling right now. I pray for those who are lonely right now. I pray that the Lord will give companionship. Hallelujah. Lasting companionship. We believe, though you think it might be dead or gone.
Yes, Lord.
Though you thought it may be long gone and your season is over. proclaim a due season.
Amen.
There's all kinds of seasons. Winter, summer, fall, spring. But there's also a season called due season.
Amen.
In a due season, we're going to reap.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If we faint not.
That's right.
If we believe. I've just come to tell you to have trust in the Lord.
Amen.
Trust in Him with all of your heart.
Amen.
Trust in Him with all of your mind.
Yep.
Don't lean to your understanding,
that's
your
right.
own understanding. Acknowledge Him in all your ways, and He's going to direct our paths. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that thing that we're stretching our hands out for, if you have a need in your life today, reach for it. I want you to take this time. We're going to take a few minutes. Just to believe,
yes,
hallelujah,
that
thing that was dead in us.
We want you to focus on the evidence.
Yes, yes, yes,
but it ain't about what you can see.
Come on, I want us to
it's
grab
what
faith.
You can see. Because what you see
hallelujah.
Is temporary.
If it's my eyes can see it, my faith is not achieving it. I'm trying to move past my eyes see and move into my faith believing.
So lift those hands, Father.
Hallelujah. We lift our hands to you today, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Praise
we
your
believe
holy
you
name.
Today, Lord.
Yes, we do.
Thank you.
We thank you today, Lord.
Yes, we do.
You're taking us, oh Lord.
Oh, yes, you are.
To a different place today, Lord.
Yes, Father.
You're taking us to a higher place today, Lord.
Yes,
that
Father.
Everything in this room.
Everything we believe in, Lord. I want you to think of something you believe in, Lord. Something you thought was dead.
Was over and that this disease
something you thought would never come back to you again.
Thank you.
I want you by faith in this prison authority to believe the Lord was high for you. Hallelujah. Whether it be complete and total healing in our bodies, it's not too far gone. Hallelujah. Lazarus was already dead, and yet he lived again.
Yes, he did.
Some of us think that we will find the person that the Most High has for us. But if you will believe, the Lord can lead and direct.
And you're going to resurrect it so big that everybody around, that's why you need the proof. The proof wasn't for you.
Hallelujah. That's right. The proof
was for everybody.
The proof was for everybody around them. It wasn't even for the Lazarus. It was for everybody that was observing and seeing with their own eyes. Whether or not the Most High could do it.
Yep.
And I proclaim to you that He can do it.
Yes, He can.
Even in your own life.
Yes,
don't give
can.
Up. Hallelujah.
We thank you today.
Yes, we do.
And I say, you shall live and not die.
Hallelujah.
See the salvation of Elohim.
Yes.
See the Lord. We come against cancer.
Yes, we do.
My mother has a testimony of cancer being removed.
Amen.
Out of the body. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Talk about the cancer that the Lord just snaps it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We speak out against brain tumors.
Amen.
Come against anybody that would have family members with blood diseases and brain tumors. I speak healing now in the name of we send it out into the airway.
Yes, we do.
Resurrect. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Go. You are dead. Hayabosha. Glory. Yet shall you live. Hallelujah. And see the salvation.
Amen.
Glory. All manner of sickness and diseases. Leukemia, we call it out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lupus, we call it out. We break the stronghold over it. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All manner of diseases and sickness. Hallelujah. It's here. We shall live again. We elevate our faith. Hallelujah. For something greater. We believe you for something greater than we see, Lord. Something greater than what our eyes can see.
Amen.
We believe in you for greater. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
We will not be moved by faith. I just feel this is the season that we must not be moved.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Crazy.
We are the testimony that He's given us on today. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're real in us. Yes, Lord. Thank you for every victory. Yes, yes, yes. Claim your victory. Yes. Hallelujah. Bless the name of God. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Financial breakthrough. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
I believe it for the land that we're believing for.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Houses and land.
That's right.
Glory. Victory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I believe in you, Lord.
Yes,
hallelujah. Lord. Yeah, we resurrect the vision. That we have the land.
That's right.
Our houses. Hallelujah.
That's right.
Manifestation of gifts.
That's right. Yes, indeed.
When I lay my hands on the sick, they will recover.
That's right.
Hallelujah. When I speak a word of prophecy, hallelujah, it will come to pass.
That's right.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
We rejoice in you, Lord.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we rejoice in you, Father, y'all. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Almighty. Lord, the King of kings and Lord of lords. Lord, King of kings and Lord of lords.
Hallelujah.
Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Most High, Yah.
Hallelujah. Yes. Resurrected me. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords. Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords. Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords. Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords.
Yes! Glory, we cast it out. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless you.
Yes.
Oh, thank you. I'm going to come out of that. Hallelujah. I'll be here for another half hour. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Almighty. Glory to the King.
I feel faith resurrecting in me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I feel hope for tomorrow resurrecting in me. Hallelujah. I feel joy resurrecting in me. Glory.
Glory. Praise the King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Almighty. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Lord. Glory to the risen one.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I think about my vision. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. When I think about all that the enemy stole from me, when he stole from us. Hallelujah. When I think about where we could have been. Hallelujah. But we resurrect that back in us. Glory, hallelujah.
Glory.
Oh, praise the great name of the Lamb. We're going to move on. Hallelujah, because I get like I get at home. I'll start ripping and running up and down. Hallelujah. I'll start taking off and turning and jumping and giving the Lord praise. Hallelujah. That is to His name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We're going to go ahead and get ready to start our, have our communion time of fellowship. Amen. Bless the Lord. Whew. Thank you for power. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. And I need to pull up the passages that we're going to speak over.
Yes.
We're going to speak over, hallelujah, our bread. Bless the Lord. If you have something that the Lord has done for you, that you're on, whoever's watching, amen, feel free to share a testimony, a victory, or whatever you're believing for. Amen. I touch and agree, hallelujah, with you over your breakthrough. Hallelujah. Amen. Bless the Almighty. Amen. So we're going to go ahead and get ready for our communion time. Oh, bless his great name. Bless his great name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we do thank you today.
Yes, God.
We praise you. We thank and praise you. Hallelujah. You are the resurrection life.
Yes, you are.
Hallelujah. And we are born anew in this kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
We are born anew. Hallelujah. And we not only do we have the spiritual manner, the manna, which is the word, we also have our communion as we remember. Amen. Bless the Almighty. We speak blessing over the bread. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Hamotzi Lechem Min Haaretz. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who brings bread from the earth.
Amen.
Concerning the cup, Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Borei Pri Hagafen. Blessed are you, O Lord, our God, ruler of the universe, creator of the fruit of the vine. We thank you for Yeshua, whose blood was spilled for our healing and our redemption. Baruch Hashem.
Baruch Hashem.
Amen. Bless the Almighty. Thank you, Lord. Amen. At this time, you can come up or I can bring it to you. You can bring it to me if you want to. Amen. Lord, we thank you for the bread. Thank you for these elements. Thank you for these elements, Father. Hallelujah. It's okay. It's okay. Yeah. Thank you for these elements. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are the bread of life. Hallelujah. Because of his body and his blood that is spilled for us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This is the bread that is for our redemption and our healing in the new covenant. We'll take it and eat it. In Yeshua's name, Baruch Hashem. Bless the Lord. Amen. This is the cup, hallelujah, that Yeshua ratified with his own blood to give us great and precious promises in the kingdom, and hallelujah, we thank him for it. In Yeshua's name we take it. Amen. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes.
Bless his name.
Bless his name.
Bless your name, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes,
bless
God.
Your name. Hallelujah. We thank him for covenant. We thank him for redemption. We thank him for the blood that was spilled on our behalf. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Amen. Bless his name. Amen. Well, that concludes this portion of our service. I don't believe I did the announcements. Yes, okay. But if you have any tithings or giftings that you want to give, I believe we have access on our website at www.ncmmi.20m.com, and you can click the donate button for PayPal to give if you choose to give via PayPal, or you can give via Cash App. Our Cash App code is $NCMMI. And we just believe that the Most High will return to you 100-fold for all of your gifts and givings. We thank the Lord how he has been so faithful to us over this past year and a half, with people from far and near. The blessings have been tremendous, and how people we did not even expect to give have been sharing and giving. And the Lord has been really meeting the needs in that area, and we're just so thankful, and we ask the Lord to give back to you, pressed down, shaken together, running over. May men give into your bosom. So we just believe we have that kind of faith.
Amen.
To believe that the Lord honors our gifts, and he has been faithful to give unto us. Amen. Amen. I had something I want to end with. Should have had it prepped. Sorry. It just came back to me. If I can find it. If I can, I will. If I can't, then I won't. It's the blessing that we usually speak at the end. Amen. If we can't find it, it'll be okay. I'm not going to do the Yay Barakaka. I had it. I believe I can find it real quick. If not, it's okay. All right, well. All right. Well, we're going to go ahead and bring our service to a close. And we just thank the Almighty for all that he has done in us, all that he's given us to say and to do. And we pray that we had some impact or touch someone on today in their heart, that they would have their needs met in Yeshua's name. Amen.
Amen.
So, Lord, we thank you for this day. We ask that you would bless us. Yes. Keep us as we go on our way, Lord, that we would keep our mind stayed on you, and that we will continue to find favor with you, O Father. We thank you in Yeshua's name. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to end it out with a song. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If not, we can just go ahead and shut it down.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Shalom and blessings to everyone. Amen.
God.